Trophic cascade is a very sciencey sounding word for nature's domino effect. Everything is interconnected, so when you push one domino over, things start to get messy fast. The bugs eat the grass, the birds eat the bugs, the snakes eat the birds, and so on. So if you take away the snakes, the birds become overpopulated and eat too many bugs. Then there aren't enough bugs to eat the grass, and the grass ends up taking over other native plants. See how everything gets thrown out of whack when you remove just one part of the equation? There are some fascinating examples of trophic cascades and the effects they have on both nature and people. Like this thing that happened in India several years ago. The vultures there have gone through some pretty rough times, and while vultures may not be everyone's favorite animal, their disappearance has caused a ripple effect, and it has cost the country billions of dollars. Before the 1990s, vultures in India were doing great. There were millions of them, and they had a respected place in Hindu mythology and culture. They were also highly revered for the ecosystem services they provided, mainly being nature's cleanup crew. Anytime there were dead animal carcasses laying around, no need to worry, the vultures would be there soon enough to take care of it for free. But suddenly, the birds faced a huge problem. In India, many people live in close proximity to livestock animals like goats, buffaloes, and cows. And when the animals you're raising get sick, you give them medicine. A drug called diclofenac was introduced in the mid-90s. It was a non-steroidal, anti-inflammatory used to treat livestock for issues like swelling or pain during birth. It was quite healing for the cattle, but it turned out to be extremely toxic for the vultures. Anytime the cleanup crew ate dead livestock that had recently been dosed with diclofenac, those birds ended up with a healthy, or I guess, unhealthy dose of the drug as well. Enough of the drug would send these birds into renal failure, leading to death. And the die-off was nothing trivial. Vulture populations in India declined an estimated 96 to 99% between 1992 and 2003. The species most affected were the long-billed vulture, the slender-billed vulture, and the oriental white-backed vulture. With a rapid decline of not one, not two, but three vulture species, the cleanup crew became severely short-staffed. Suddenly, the streets were littered with dead animal carcasses, which is an issue on its own, so the government started funding efforts to clean them up. But dead animals on the side of the road aren't just an eyesore that make me sad. When you live in close proximity to so many carcasses, disease can start to spread. Carcasses are a breeding ground for deadly pathogens that cause tuberculosis, brucellosis, and other zoonotic diseases. As the flesh decays and rots, those pathogens can infect humans through the water we drink or through contact with other animals that have eaten it, like dogs. When India's primary scavengers declined, others started to show up in larger numbers, including dogs. And with more dogs came more dog bites. Feral dog populations are hard to track, but the number of them in India increased by an estimated 5 to 7 million individuals from the early 90s to the early 2000s. And unfortunately, in India, dogs are one of the main vectors for the spread of rabies, accounting for up to 96% of cases. Left untreated, rabies will be fatal. Not might, will. Always. This increase in the spread of diseases has resulted in tens of thousands of additional human deaths and a huge financial burden for the government, with rabies alone costing an estimated $34 billion annually from 1992 to 2006. It's hard to know exactly what the total cost of this vulture die-off was, but looking at the estimated cost of rabies cases, carcass removal, and conservation efforts, we're talking more than $150 billion over the course of 14 years. Now, this all looks really bleak. And that's because it was, but the situation has begun to improve. Diclofenac, remember that was the drug that was the catalyst for this whole nightmare, was banned in 2006. People with livestock began using a newer, safer drug called meloxicam in its place. Since then, India's vulture populations have stabilized. Conservationists have created captive breeding programs in an effort to boost the population. And not every individual vulture died. There are actually a few strongholds of populations that live farther away from people. Out in the forests, they're far from agricultural disturbances, and there are plenty of hoofed animals for them to chow down on without fear that they have been dosed with diclofenac. So while the vultures aren't entirely out of the woods yet, and I guess maybe they shouldn't be since that's where some of them live, things are starting to look up for them. Hopefully, lots of these eerie yet iconic birds will be back to flying circles over dead animals in the near future.